Hello everyone, welcome to Engineering Exploration course presentation by Team 15. Members of our Team 15 are Vinayak S. Dandreddy, myself Omkar S. Patil, Nutan and Pallavi. We are under guidance of Sri Vinay Talgeri sir. Our Engineering Exploration course project is on drill bit dispenser. The first stop of this journey was identifying objectives, functions, constraints and defining the problem definition with these. So here is the problem definition. The need statement was, Tinkering Lab is in need of an automatic drill bit dispenser which should be able to dispense and collect drill bits after student authentication. So we define the problem as design an automatic drill bit dispenser which should be able to dispense the bits of desired size, and it should be portable and user friendly. The machine must be able to scan the identity card and store the details of the user. It should dispense one drill bit at a time. The budget should not exceed ₹4,000 to ₹6,000. Machine should display the details of the user at the end of the day who have not returned the drill bits. So to summarize, the features are: display the name of the student who have not returned the drill bits at the end of the day. Alert signal should be given when there are less than 5 drill bits. And proper storage should be provided to store the drill bits of different sizes and the machine parts. And there should be platform to hold the dispensed drill bit. And the dispensing should happen one by one according to the user input. And the machine should be portable, and it should be able to identify the student that he is from KLE Tech University by scanning his identity card, and there should be provision for refilling the machine. So coming to next process, it was of identifying the functions and forming the function tree and clustering the functions. Here is the function tree. The functions we have identified are identification function, storage function, dispensing function, refilling function and notification function. In identification function, the subfunctions are scanning and storing the scanned information. In storage, making proper slots according to the size of the drill bits and storing the components of machines such as Arduino board. In dispensing, dispense the drill bits one at a time, dispense the required drill bit and platform to collect the dispensed drill bit. In refilling, one or more slot to collect the return drill bits and provision to refill the machine by the owner. At last, in notification function, the subfunctions are notification to be given after lending, receiving and when the drill bits are less in number. Display the details at the end of the day. Coming to functional clustering, we have identified 4 subunits. These are identification unit, storing unit, dispensing unit and notification unit. In identification unit, it consists of identification function. In storing unit, it consists of storage function and refilling function. In dispensing unit, it consists of dispensing function. And in notification unit, it consists of notification function.
So the next slide explains you the subsystem identified in our course project. The first one is identification, or also called as authentication unit, and information gathering unit, storing unit, dispensing unit and notifying unit. These are the 4 concepts generated by my teammates. The first concept was generated by Nutan. This is how the machine looks in her conceptual designing. It has a following subsystem, that is authentication unit, refilling unit, storing unit, casing unit. We basically use the gravitational force for dispensing the drill bit. We store the drill bit in a circular disk which contains several partitions to hold the drill bit in the circular way. Once the input is given, the motor attached to the disk rotates in angle, making the next drill bit to come to the place of dispensing part. Once it is at the place, the drill bit falls in the holder due to the gravitational force. And the concept 2 was generated by me. This is how the machine looks in my conceptual design. It has a following subsystem: refilling unit, authentication unit, storing unit, casing unit. The machine stores 3 mm, 5 mm, 6 mm standard drill bits. The mechanism which this machine uses to dispense the drill bit is that it consists of a gas spring rod which has pressurized gas inside it. If the user is in the need of any of the standard drill bit, and one thing, the drill bits are stored in a horizontal fashion as shown in the figure. If the user is in the need of any standard drill bit, then he can apply the force on the rear end of the gas spring, and this force is traversed through the pressurized gas and which compresses the gas, and the gas in turn applies the force to the rod, and this in turn the rod applies the force to the drill bit, making it to fall down. And the gas has a property to expand by itself so that it comes to the original position as the earlier by making the drill bit to fall on the conveyor belt, and the conveyor belt rotates and make to fall on the dispensing platform. And the concept 3 was generated by Omkar. This is how the machine looks in his conceptual designing. It has a following subsystem: refilling unit, authentication unit, storing unit, casing unit. The drill bits are stored on the conveyor belt in a linear fashion. The machine stores 3 mm, 5 mm, 6 mm standard drill bit. The mechanism which this machine uses to dispense the standard drill bit is that motor rotates for a few milliseconds, and in coordinating, the belt also moves in the same direction and makes the drill bit to fall down, as you can see in the design. And the concept 4 was generated by Pallavi. This is how the machine looks in her conceptual designing. It has a following subsystem: refilling unit, authentication unit, storing unit, casing unit. The drill bits are stored in a vertical fashion. As you can see in the slide, the machine stores 3 mm, 4 mm, 5 mm standard drill bits. The mechanism which the machine uses to dispense the standard drill bit is that machine has got a 3D printed part which we named as dispenser, on which the drill bits are stored in the vertical fashion, and the motor rotates for 90 degrees and make to fall the topmost drill bit down, and so that the next drill bit also comes in position with this part. And the concept which we selected was concept 4, based on several advantages over the other.
Let's come to the virtual implementation part. It includes 3D model of the entire system, circuit diagram of entire system, flowchart, bill of materials required for the entire system, motor sizing and battery sizing of the entire system. Let's come to the 3D modeling. We have prepared the separate 3D models for particular subsystem and integrated them to form 3D model of the entire system. Our system includes 4 subsystems, namely identification and information gathering unit, storing unit, dispensing unit, and notification unit. For identification, we have used the RFID scanner, which scans the ID card of the student and allow him to operate the machine if he was validated, and it asks the user for input so that user have to give the required input like 3 mm or 4 mm so that it operates based on the input. And then comes to the storing part. Here we can see that the drill bits were stored in a vertical manner, and there is a separate slots are they made for particular sized drill bits. And here is an empty slot, which is for restoring the drill bits after the usage. When drill bits were less in number or empty, here is a provision provided to add the drill bits manually by the owner. Then comes the dispensing unit. It includes those DC motors for particular sized drill bit. Based on the input, DC motor rotates for 90 degrees and dispenses the drill bits. The dispensed drill bit is collected in its platform. And then comes the notification part. When drill bits are less in number, like less than 5 or 10, the notification is sent to the owner so that he can refill the drill bits. And it also gives the notification and details like how many drill bits were used today, that and all, at the end of the day. And then comes the circuit diagram of the entire system. This is RFID scanner, this is a display, and these are the DC motors, particularly for 3, 4, and 5 mm. And the wire connected from DC motor to this board, and then to display, and then to the RFID scanner, and all wires were integrated in this Arduino. This is all about the circuit diagram of entire system.
Now we have the flowchart for our entire system. The system starts once the input is given to the computer. If the input is 3 or 4 millimeter, then the DC motor rotates for 90 degrees and the drill bit is dispensed. The DC motor stops and waits for the next input. The system indicates when the number of drill bits is less than 6 and the buzzer beeps, thus notifying the user to reload the drill bits. If the input is other than 3 or 4 millimeter, then it is invalid input and the system stops. Next, we have bill of materials required for the entire system. For our system, we will be using two DC motors made up of brass metal, plastic sheet, etc. Specification of the DC motor is 1000 RPM, one rotation for 90 degrees clockwise. Next, we will be using a platform made up of foam sheet of diameter 15 × 5 × 10 cm. And the fabrication is done by the process of cutting. Next, we will be using housing or casing made up of acrylic or foam sheet of dimensions 80 × 20 × 15 cm. Fabrication is done by the process of cutting. Next, we will be using two dispensers, which is made up of acrylic sheet, and the length of the dispenser is equal to the drill bit length semicircle. Diameter of the dispenser is equal to the diameter of the drill bit. Fabrication is done by the process of laser cutting. Next, we will be using 10 nuts and bolts made up of metal of dimensions 2 mm, 3 mm, 4 mm and 6 mm. Next, we have motor sizing and battery sizing of the entire system. By motor sizing, we come to know the specification of the DC motor to be used. This can be found out by calculating the tension, which is equal to force into the radius. And the force experienced by the drill bit is the gravitational force. Thus, the tension is equal to gravitational force into radius, that is half the diameter. Thus, the tension we get is 0.294 Newton meter. Therefore, we need motor with 1000 RPM. For our system, battery sizing is not applicable as our system runs with the help of power supply.
So the next PPT explains you about the modeling and simulation of our course project. This is the circuit connection and the code which we have written for our course project. This circuit connection and the code helps in dispensing the two standard drill bits, that is 3mm and 4mm, for the user. If the user is in the requirement of a 3mm drill bit, then he can enter 3 on the serial monitor and the DC motor 1, which is this, as shown, rotates for 90 degrees and dispenses of the 3mm drill bit. As you can see that user enters 3 on the serial monitor, then DC motor 1 rotates for 90 degrees and also shows that 3mm drill bit is dispensed off from the machine. And if the user is in the need of 4mm drill bit, then he can enter 4 on the serial monitor and DC motor which rotates for a 90 degree and dispenses of the 4mm drill bit for the user. As you can see that motor 2 rotates for 90 degree and dispenses of the 4mm drill bit. And the delay which we have given for the motor to rotate for 90 degrees is 25 milliseconds. Thank you.